I'll say MySQL also list.
We can save memory with different things, homogeneous things.
Okay.
In the same way.
Mm-hmm.
Like multiple variables, we can save multiple variable value in a same place.
Okay. Good. Anyone others can try? Try, no problem. Yeah, we can save same type of the data. Okay. I don't know, your voice is coming very slow. Okay, you can speak. I am little bit able to hear. Okay, go ahead. Okay, we have some advantage and disadvantage. First thing, Y array, if you want to store multiple data, okay, I have to store, you know, 10 variables, okay. So normally, like, if you will store like that, I did not share my screen. Oh yeah, I said right. If you will store like that, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, like that, A7, I'm not taking this. So if you want to store multiple data, yeah, multiple value, then what, like that, one approach to storing like that. But what is the problem of this approach? You can see every, you know, element having the one variable. So what happened, if you will go in the real time, if you want to store 100 data, 1000 data, then how to store? We cannot do like multiple type like that. What is the problem of that? If you will do like that, what happened? Your performance of the code and readability of the code is not good, right? So this is not, you know, valid. You cannot store multiple data like that. So we have a concept called array. So what is the job of an array? If you want to be a store multiple data in a single variable, okay, you can store same type and you can store different type also. So I will come on the point. First thing, why we use an array? If you want to be a store multiple data, so we cannot use, you know, like that. So what happened, it will consume more memory and readability of the code will not good, performance of the code, then that's why we are going for array concept. Okay, so this is not recommended to use. Now okay, so what is the meaning of this? First we will understand this part, okay, first we will understand this part, then I will come on this. Okay, so what happened, here when you are writing new keyword, when we are writing a new keyword, one object is created. This new means one object is created. Okay, this is the type. I have given the int type. I want to store int type, you know, data, and this is your location, or you can tell this is your size. So I am not going to this part, just we are concentrating on this part now. So new means it will create an object. Okay, this is your location. Yeah, you can tell this is your size is 5. So what happened, and int is a data type, you can give any types, okay, data types. So this is your data types and this is your location or your size. So now one object is created and we have given this 5 location. Okay, now here we have a 5 location. Okay, so array is working on index. Okay, array is working on index. So now it will start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so first, what is the meaning of new? One object is created. Inside this, we have a location. Yeah, we have a size. So we have a size. Okay, so now int means this is your data type. So why we are writing the data type? Because we have to tell to compiler and JVM the types. If you will not tell the types, then compiler is which type it will store, right? They will ask compile time error. If you will do the different syntax, if you will use, then compiler will tell you, hey, what type you want to store, tell me. Okay, so this is the type we have to give. So now I am going to store int type. Okay, now I am going to store int type. So that's why I have given this int. And we have a location. This part is over internally. Okay, we have given the int type. So default value of int here is 0. Okay, it will initialize in all location. Okay, now when you are writing these steps, this one dimensional array, then this internally happened. One object new means one object is created. We have given the location, so we have a location of 5. So in the array is working on the index, so index is starting from 0, and we have given the int type. So int type default value is 0. Now this is your, now what I am going to do, I am holding this object. Okay, so I am going to hold this object. So now what happened, this is your A, this is called referenced variable. Okay, this is called referenced variable. If you will display this A, then what happened, you will get hash code. Okay, if you will display this, you will get hash code. Hash code is nothing but it is a random number which is generated by JVM. So coming classes, I will explore this. I will completely teach you array or collection, because in the real time you have a lot of the thing will come on this array and collection. Okay, so I will teach you completely array and collection concept, and after that you guys will tell if you have any doubt regarding any topic. Let me know, I will give you the extra class for code Java also. Okay, so now this thing is happened here, and now this is your reference variable holding this object. This is array type. You know, we have given int type of an array. So this will what, because we have to give the type, right? So we have to tell to JVM and compiler, right? This is the int type of an array. Sorry. Hey, my voice is not audible, all of you?
No, I'm good here.
Even I'm good here.
Ram, I think in your side some issue is there. I don't know why it is coming, because these guys are able to hear me. Check your earphone, or might be some network issue is there. I can't help you for this now, but this is recording session, and try to fix what the problem you are facing. Okay, next session try to fix, and recording session is there. If I am not able to upload today, then tomorrow I will upload. If I forget, just ping me someone, I will upload this video. And watch once, if you having the any doubt, note down this, and when I will come, so try to fix in your side. Okay, so we have this reference variable, right? So type is, what is the meaning of this? This is the int type array, that's it. This is your reference variable, and this is your new means one object is created. Inside this, we have given the location. So location is 5, so by default the value is 0. So the type will tell to JVM and compiler this is the int type. Now I want to store a of 0 equal to 1, a of 1 equal to 4, okay, a of 2 equal to 5. Okay, so now we have a 3, we have a 4. Okay, I'm not changing this value, can change this value. So how to, what happened now, I have a store inside this array. So now what happened here, 1 is there and what the value, 4 here, this will replace, 2 is there, here 5 is there, here 5 is there, here 5 is there. So now I have a store, I want to display this, how to display. So now I will use for loop here. So a dot, okay, I will explain this, wait for some time now. Okay, now my question is, you can tell me how each iteration will print here. My question is, how this for loop is working? This is, I have stored this value and I will explain this. A is the length, a dot length means this is your 5. It will find the size of an array. Okay, so my question is, how this value will display here? How this for loop is working?
I think it starts from the first array, like A0, and it comes down all the way down to A4, and it will increase by 1 by 1.
Your question is like, it will iterate like that, I equal to 0, then it will go here, then it will increment 1.
Then it comes again, and I become 1, and it will prove that, it will show that I is still less than 5, so it will increase again, and it will... until it becomes 5, it is, this loop is continuing.
Any others one can explain this for loop?
Yeah, the same thing. It will work till the length of array.
Okay. Sorry, your voice is not coming. Can you speak loudly? Okay, whatever you know, just concentrate how this for loop is working. This part is called initialization part. Okay, this is your increment and decrement. It will check the condition. This is your increment and decrement. Okay, so now first iteration we have to understand. I equal to 0. Okay, then I equal to 0. Then now 0 less than equal to 5. This is your initialization. Then after that it will check the condition. I think length spelling is wrong, right? L-A-N-G-T-H. Okay, now first iteration, the initialization, I equal to 0, then it will go control here, I less than equal to 5. This condition is true, then control will not go here. Okay, first time initialization, after that it will check the condition, then control will not go here, the control will come here. Okay, so now the value will print a of 0 equal to 1. Now this initialization job is over. Okay, then second iteration, the control will go here, then now a of 1, it will go here, increment a will increment 1, then again it will check, you know, I value. I value is 1 greater than 5, then it will display. Okay, so now the control will go here. Again, it will go increment, and again it will check the condition. This initialization happened only one times. Okay, first time the control will not go here. First time the initialization, then it will check the condition, then control will come here. Now the initialization job is over. Okay, like that for loop is working. Okay, so again it will go increment, and again it will what? Print the value. Increment, check condition, and print the value. Increment, check condition, print the value from second iteration. So like that this for loop is working. Okay, I think it is clear now. So now I'm going to print this. Okay, so now we are getting this, you know, all the output. You can use this like that also. Okay, so same thing. You can store direct value, same thing here. Okay, whatever here it's happening, the memory diagram is also same. Okay, so if you don't have a, you know, this size, so you have to use this one, because we don't have a size how many value you want to store, so that's why we are using this one. Okay, so now what I'm going to do here, okay, sorry. So just I comment this. So memory diagram is same for this. Okay, so now if I will compile this, okay, so now we are getting the this value, whatever I have stored here. So internally same thing going to happen when you are writing this using this LibreAccess by using this, okay, like this syntax. Okay, so first why we use array, if you want to be a store multiple data in a single variable. Okay, so you know, then we will go for the array. So what is the advantage? The advantage of this, we are storing the multiple data in a single variable, right? Before you can see one variable, I am storing only one. You can see in one variable you can store the multiple data. This is your advantage, right? So it is very fast as compared to this, because it will increase the, you know, readability of the code and performance of the code. But we have some disadvantage also, so I will discuss this also. Okay, so introduction, array declaration, creation, initialization, array declaration, creation, initialization in a single unit, length via length variable, anonymous array element assignment, array variable assignment. So we will discuss all the point. So what is an array? Okay, so array is an index collection of fixed number of homogeneous data element. This sentence we have to modify. Okay, first thing, that this is the true, it is fixed. If you have an advanced like we have a, you know, size of an array, how many, you know, data you want to store, but someone will tell you, no, I have to, again the requirement is changed. If you want to store more, whatever the size you have fixed, then what happens? We will not get compile time error, but runtime you will get error. Okay, so runtime will get error. So here this is the disadvantage of an array. So array index out of bound exception, because the size is fixed. So one disadvantage. So here it, same thing I have written, an array is index collection of fixed number of homogeneous. What is the meaning of homogeneous? If you want to store, okay, so what happens if I will compile this? So we are getting this error. Error is showing incompatible type, lossy conversion double from int. So this is called homogeneous. If you want to, we have given the int type, but I'm going to store double, you are going to store a character, yeah, string. So what happened? You will get error, incompatible type. So same thing I have mentioned. So first thing, array is an index collection of fixed number homogeneous element. My another question is, can we store heterogeneous in array?
Yes, we can in an object class, I think.
Yes. So we can store heterogeneous type by using the object class of an array. So coming classes, I will give you the example of this. So the main advantage of an array is we can represent multiple values by using a single variable so that the readability and understanding of the code will improve. The main disadvantage of an array is fixed in size. Once we create an array with some size, then there is no chance for increment and decrement on the size based on our requirement, right? So hence we use array concept compulsory. We should know the size in advance, which is not be possible. So these are the disadvantage of an array. Okay, so another disadvantage of an array is, you know, in collection I will give you another introduction, again I will come with an array. So another disadvantage of an array is we don't have an inbuilt method. Inbuilt method means I have a logic, I want to be a delete some element from the array, then we don't have a delete and any inbuilt logic, right? But in the collection we have a remove. We can simply call this method and we can use this. But if you are using an array, then you have to write in your logic. What happened? It will make, you know, complexity of the code. So this is the another disadvantage of an array. Another disadvantage of an array is if you want to be a store data, so it will get the output in the insertion order. Okay, so you cannot get the output from in your requirement. So this is the another disadvantage of an array. Another disadvantage, we have a homogeneous type you can store, but this problem, type problem, by using the object type class of an array we are able to resolve this. So sometimes the interviewer will ask, can we store heterogeneous type in array? Your question is yes. If you will use the object class of an array, we can store heterogeneous type also. Okay, so whatever the disadvantage, so big disadvantage of the size problem, so that's why the solution of collection. So collection is nothing but it is a global an array, like, you know, a spring. You can remove, you can delete, in between you can do anything, like it is a flexible array. Internal data structure of collection is only array, but it is a flexible. Okay, so I will come in the collection, then I will explain later. So how to declare an array? So array declaration, one dimensional array. So this is the way, you know, how to declare this an array. I will execute this. This example is there in my notes, so I will send you. Okay, so I'm using inside this one class only. Actually, if you are strong in Java, then you can play with Selenium. If you are not good in Java, then you will stuck in Selenium. So we are not learning for as a fresher, right? You can go as a 5-year experience. You can work in the company, and you can, if you are getting the confidence, then why they will not get the job? That is the thing. So this is, you know, here a space is not matters. Okay, so this you can declare like that, but apart from this, all are, you know, this is also, this is not, error will not come here. You can declare like that also. Okay, so you can declare, like, you can see here the we have given this a space, but the space is didn't matter for us. But this is the invalid syntax. If you will uncomment and execute this, you will get error, because this is the not a way of declaration. So how to declare one dimensional array? So at the time of array declaration, we cannot specify the size, otherwise we will get compile time error. So at the time of declaration, if you are going to do like this, you are giving the size, then what happened? We will get compile time error. So we are getting this compile time error, right? Illegal start expression. So you cannot do this. Okay, so how to declare the two dimensional array? So this is the same like that. Okay, just here a space is there. You can see we have a space. Okay, you can see we have a space. so it doesn't matter. So but here the same variable I have given, so if I will compile this, it will give the error. Just I am changing this variable. So 2D array is will use in data provider, right? So data provider we will use in the Selenium in the 2D array. This okay, so 2D array I will teach you. Okay, so this is the way of declaration of 2D array. Okay, so now we have a 3D also, but you can see only I am showing the declaration, I will not go in the 3D, not huge here. Okay, so if you will change this variable, it will compile. You can compile in your system also. Same thing, a space is there. Okay, so you can declare 3D like that also. Okay, just you can change this variable, it will execute, it will compile. So I am not going to this. Okay, so yeah, if you will declare like that, multiple variable are there, right? If you are creating any array 1D, 2D and 3D, but you can see only one variable is there. If you will do you like that, then you will get error. Okay, so this is a not a way of declaration, illegal start, not a statement. Okay, so this is the small point will help you in the real time. Okay, so array creation, how to create an array, I already discussed this. Every array in the Java is an object, hence we can create an array by using the new operator. So I already discussed, right? For every array type, the corresponding classes are available. These classes are the part of Java language, not as applicable for the programmer. What is this? If you are creating any array, no, array is also a class. That class is called corresponding classes. Okay, this class is called corresponding classes. So how to know this regarding this corresponding classes? So we have a small piece of the code. So by using this, this thing is not required for your coding purpose, but knowledge purpose. Okay, so I am teaching the completely, otherwise I will not teach. That is my agenda. Okay, so you can see array having the corresponding classes. You know, when we are creating an object, class name, reference variable, new class name or parenthesis, that is called constructor. So internally, if you will go in the internally, this is called corresponding classes. Okay, so we have a one inbuilt class method, get class and get name. So by using this, we can get the corresponding classes. So when we are going to execute this, so you can see we are getting this corresponding classes. So these are the list of the corresponding classes I have written. So int type we have this. Okay, you can use, you can execute sort, you will get long and plot. Okay, so this is, you know, corresponding classes. So 2D array, if I will execute this, this is the inbuilt class which is available in the Java API. Okay, get class and get name. So you can see the what the corresponding classes is coming. 2D is coming, you know, double, this is a square. Okay, so this is, you know, corresponding classes. So we have a this example I have already shown you. Okay, so here you cannot take the size as a negative. If you will try the size as a negative, then you will not get a runtime, sorry, compile time error, you will get runtime. So if I will try to compile this, so sorry, I did not give this. Okay, so size is, you know, if you will give the size negative, then we will get runtime error. So java.lang negative array size exception. So it won't be come as a compile time, it will come as a runtime. So two exception, array out of bound exception coming runtime, not a compile time. When you declare negative size, then we will get error. That error is called negative array size exception. Okay, so two exception is there. Okay, so can we give the size as a zero? Yes, you can give. So we have also a proof of this. We can give the size as a zero. Okay, so when we'll compile this, so you can see here. Okay, so I'm not executing this now. So I have given the size and I'm finding the size of the array. So what if length is a variable. So by using this length variable, we can find the size of an array. Okay, so when I will execute this, able to compile and able to execute. So we are getting the zero. This, a string args is also, you know, a string type of an object. A string type of an array. Arg is variable, right? When you are writing this like that, or when you are writing this, so both are same, right? Both are same here. Okay. So this is, you know, if I will find the size of a string of an array, then we are getting the size is zero. So from here you can prove this, because this main method developed by the Java people. So why, if I will find the size of args, then we will get zero also. Okay. So we are getting this zero. So from here we can prove this, yes, we can give the size as a zero, and we are not getting compile time and runtime error. So by using this we can also find. Okay, so how to find the size? I think no need to execute this. So we already discussed this, right, in this example also. So by using this length variable, you can find the size of an array. That's it. Okay. Here we have one question, but it's not. It looks like only, but not detail. So just I am going to execute this code. Okay, so it looks like lengthy, but not a lengthy. Just for your practice purpose, whatever we learn this now. Okay, so just this thing I took, like, just we are going to print this value. That's it. So one variable is there, and one constructor is there. So this is your class level variable, right? Non-static class level variable. This is user-defined class, right? So I have created one constructor and passing this, you know, int x value. Why we are using this? What is the use of constructor? So by using the constructor, we can initialize an object. So this constructor is called parameterized constructor. Why it is a parameterized constructor? We are passing the parameters here. Okay, this variable. Okay, now we have used this keyword dot x. Okay, here. Why we are using this keyword? It will refer the current variable here. So what is the current variable here? X. If we will not use this keyword, then output will come null. Okay, so why we are using this keyword? Because it will refer the current variable, your current object, you can tell, whatever the thing is there. So by using this keyword, and this keyword is applicable for only non-static. If you will go in the this is also a big topic. Okay, so that's why I use here, that's it. Okay, in the collection I will give you some example of this type of example. I will explain once. Okay, just I have created an object and passing this argument here 10. Okay, so this is not a big deal, this is not related to array. So here I have created a double type of an array, and one is a float type of an array, and just we are printing this. So double type, one more thing here, one more conclusion is there. You cannot keep the size as a double or float. If you will keep the size, then you will get error. Okay, so size is only, you cannot give the negative, you cannot give the double or float type. Okay, if you will try to do this, then what happens? You will get incompatible type. But double type you can use. Okay, type is double, we can use this. Okay, so now just I am going to print this L1. So L1 will come here 9 only, right? L1 will come here 9 only. Okay, so just we are printing the size. Just here I want to show you, double type, if you are passing this size as a double or float, it won't be allowed, you will get error. But type you can create. Okay, so in the float, just we are passing same value here, 9, right? So if I will print I2, same size will print, because just we are finding the size from here, again we are passing the size from here, so 9 only will get, right? Okay, so 9 9, we are getting this. This is the purpose of this example. This purpose I want to show you here. This is one thing, and this is the different, this is the double type, and this is your size you are passing this. Okay, so don't confuse this. So what is the difference between simple object and array object? So here I have mentioned here. So this is called reference variable test class, and this is called reference variable of test. So when we are creating an simple object, so like this object will be created only, right? And this is your reference variable. Okay, like this is your reference variable 2020, you can write here. So this is only difference between simple object and array object. Okay, so same thing I have mentioned here. In this class I have mentioned same thing. Okay, I think you are able to understand this, what I want to tell. Here I took the test. Okay, so I'm not created for test, just I am comparing with this. So this is your, you know, array object. Okay, and this is your simple object. So this is your difference between array object and simple object. Okay, so you can execute, but we have a one we have this example of this. So what, okay, so this is, you can learn something from in this example also. Okay, so in this example, just I explore this, some confusion is there in this example. So just I want to, so just we have created one object of the test demo, like this is your simple object. We have a one of object, array object class, right? So you can see which type I took this array. This is the type of class test data. Data type, you know. We have a int, plot, double, right? A string, char. Same, we have a class data type. Okay, so which type it is there? This is the demo test class type. Okay, so don't confuse. Class is a class name is also the data type. So which type? Class type. Okay, so this is the class type, right? Demo test class type of an array is created here, array object. When you will print this value, this is called your referenced variable. So what happened, it will create an it will print a hash code. So hash code is nothing but, it is a random number which is generated by JVM. Okay, when this object is there, if you want to print this object only, okay, what happened, when you are printing, I'm not holding this object, only this object is there. This object. Okay, when you are creating an object, then one hash code is also generated here. Your question is, what is the difference between this object and simple object? Why we are creating an object? If you want to, you know, we have a non-static member. If you want to, we are, you know, access the non-static member, then we have to create an object. When you are creating an object, the non-static member will get memory when creating an object. So how to access? So by using this reference variable we can access, right? So this is the difference between, but if you are simple creating an object, we cannot access any member from any class, right? Member means a static variable, non-static variable, method. So how to access this? But simple object, if you will print this simple object, only hash code will print here. Okay, so this is your only simple one hash code is print here. Okay, because every object have a unique number. I can give you one example. If you can take any database, right, in company, yeah, in college, anything, like in a bank customer, so every customer have a information. So every customer is an object in the real time. One object, I have a name, PAN card, Aadhaar card, right? This is your three main thing you require to open the bank account. So your data will store, right? So one customer have one object. So one object is created, this is a unique. Because the, might be the name is different, but object is unique. One object is unique. Why it is a unique? Because one hash code is there. So that is a unique number. In the real time, if you will go in the people are developing the application, so how the data they are storing. Okay, so in the collection, they are using the collection. So collection, we are storing. In the collection, everything is an object. Okay, so if you are storing one array list is there, if you will store one value, 1, 2, 3 in the array list, this is one object is created. Okay, so in collection, everything is an object. So how they are verifying this, right? So same thing here. This is the, you know, important thing. Okay, so that's why I have given this point. So don't confuse with creating an object. So only hash code will print here. You can see here. So this is a simple object, right? This is a simple object reference variable. You can see when we are printing this, when we are printing this array type of an object, sorry, reference variable, you can see here the one what you can take square braces is coming, half a square braces, right? So this is, you know, difference. Okay, so type we have to remember, this is a class type, like we are writing no int array we are creating, then we have to tell to the compiler and JVM this is the int type. The class is also the type. So which type? Class type. Okay, so that's why I have given this example. So what is the difference between simple length variable and simple length variable and length method? Okay, so we know that, just we'll explore this. We'll talk to code. We will not talk to word. We will talk to code. That's it. So now we have a how to difference, how to find what is the difference between length variable and length method. So length method is, I think, in the string length method is also there, inbuilt method, but this method I have created, this is a user defined method. Okay, length is a variable. By using the length variable, we can find the size of an array. By using the length method, you know, method means we can, you know, create a logic inside this method. So user defined method just I have created, so I want to show you the what is the difference between, you know, both. So just I have created one method that is, you know, int type and returning this 10 value, that's it. And we have created an array, that's it, the demo test array type, class type of an array. I have given the size is 3. Again, just I have created one object, simple object, and we are finding this size. Okay, so it will find the size and it will find the length of an array, that's it. We are calling this method only. How to access this? That's why I have created an object. Right now I am going to access this. So it will get this out 10. Here we'll get the size 3. So this is the difference between array and length variable and length method. This is the one thing. This is not related to a static or non-static, that's it. So to specify array size, allowed data type. So which data type is allowed? Byte, sort, at, char, int. This is the allowed. Maximum allowed array size in Java, this one, this is the big numbers. So you should not remember this, just your knowledge purpose I have given this. Okay, so we have a 2D array. So tomorrow I will take your class. Okay, tomorrow